On October 29, 2012, New Jersey found itself with the largest Atlantic storm ever recorded. Residents were confronted with a level of destruction most New Jerseyans had never before experienced. More than 2.4 million New Jersey residents were without power. More than 40,000 homes and apartments sustained major damage during the storm. With the support of state and federal agencies, recovery began almost immediately. Emergency officials moved rapidly to conduct inspections, expedite the removal of the debris that littered the landscape, obstructing roads, rail lines, and waterways, and hundreds of homes had been damaged to such a degree that they were in imminent danger of collapse. Public assistance grants reimbursed state and local governments and certain nonprofits for eligible disaster-related costs of response and recovery efforts. These include overtime pay for emergency responders, debris removal, and the repair, reconstruction, or replacement of eligible public facilities and infrastructure, such as roads and bridges. The FEMA mission for individuals was to provide safe, secure, and sanitary shelter for New Jerseyans displaced by the storm. FEMA launched its housing mission in cooperation with the New Jersey state-led Disaster Housing Task Force. Assistance included temporary housing, rental assistance, transitional lodging in hotels and motels, and grants to repair and replace storm-ravaged primary residences. Businesses in 113 of New Jersey's 565 municipalities lost more than $382 million in commercial property and an estimated $64 million in losses from the interruption of their businesses. The U.S. Small Business Administration got into gear to provide help to homeowners, renters, and businesses who needed to repair and rebuild or replace personal property by providing low-interest loans to cover these major costs. Members of FEMA Corps implemented its FEMA for Kids program in New Jersey. FEMA for Kids visited 21 schools and community-based programs in areas affected by Sandy. FEMA Corps members also created FEMA Connect, a similar program for high school students. It had more than 600 participants in New Jersey. Hazard mitigation is the only phase of emergency management specifically dedicated to breaking the cycle of damage, reconstruction, and repeated damage. Projects eligible for hazard mitigation grant program funds include retrofitting buildings to minimize damage from high winds and flooding, elevation of flood-prone buildings, minor flood control projects, and the purchase of property at risk of repetitive flooding for conversion to open space. The Community Education and Outreach section of FEMA's Hazard Mitigation Branch promoted effective hazard mitigation ideas and techniques through community education, outreach, and training in coordination with public and private sectors to inform and educate communities and individuals about their options in regard to protecting their properties from a future disaster. Immediately after Sandy struck, FEMA's private sector division in external affairs deployed to New Jersey to work with chambers of commerce, industry associations, individual companies, colleges, and universities and other organizations. FEMA's private sector representatives conducted outreach throughout the state to inform and educate small businesses on ways to plan for business continuity and preparedness in advance of future disasters. Environmental and historic preservation specialists provide expertise and technical assistance to FEMA staff, local, state, and federal partners and applicants who are tasked with the challenge of preserving historic and natural aspects of our national heritage. They help applicants understand what is required under the law and how best to meet those requirements. After a major disaster, Federal Disaster Recovery Coordination is activated by FEMA to provide communities with a team of community recovery assistance specialists who have a broad array of technical skills and local knowledge. A community recovery assistance team will help the community set goals and also guide the planning process. The team works with the entire community to identify and develop funding sources, resilient design strategy, business recovery, and long-term recovery strategies. They are available to provide technical assistance throughout the recovery phase, however long it takes. 1 year after the storm, though much remains to be done, New Jerseyans are moving forward with the continuing assistance of volunteers and the many agencies committed to assisting with the long-term recovery process.